Britain is on the way to a three-headed national crisis on immigration, a collapse in the NHS and a massive hike in the cost of living. Nigel Farage has warned as he mulls over a return to frontline politics. The former Brexit Party leader turned Labour presenter on GB News told that he is receiving daily pleas in his email box to return to the political scene. Speaking, he pointed out that he was mocked 20 months ago when he first started covering the Channel crossings by illegal migrants. But now, in a week where 27 died after one of the dinghies capsized, he believes the UK is heading towards a national emergency. He said, "I think it is possible that by the spring or summer of next year the Channel crossings by migrants, will become a national emergency. I think the numbers that will come will dwarf what you are currently seeing. I've not been wrong on a single prediction on this." He went on, "We are heading for a national crisis. There are three key areas of our national life right now: the migration crisis, the looming health crisis, and the cost of living. Those three issues trump everything. Already we are being told you want a hip operation, drive 400 miles, an NHS that simply can't cope. Nobody dares own up to it. Inflation is a disease of money caused by government. This government is borrowing and borrowing. Even a conservative budget foresees a deficit of £100 billion next year. Addiction to QE. Asset pumping, the rich getting disproportionately richer. Nobody in Westminster seems to get it. With the row with France and hundreds of migrants still making the dangerous crossing over the Channel this week, Mr. Farage pointed out that he was the first to raise the issue. I have been on this for 20 months. When I did my first YouTube film, I went to visit the South Coast to start to raise awareness of it. I've been on it almost every day since. Again, it is the classic thing. I thought this would become a huge issue. Most people didn't. But once again, I picked an issue I have been right about. I always pick an issue I am right about. I could see 20 months there was a big sign on the white cliffs of Dover, "Everybody welcome. You won't be deported," he added. "You can put 20,000 police on the beaches in France, but if the pull factors remain as strong here, namely 4-star accommodation, 3 square meals a day, healthcare, dental care, spending money, and the massive illegal economy that thrives in Britain with slave conditions. Although nobody dares want to talk about that, whether it is in Leicester or wherever it is." He believes that the Prime Minister and Conservatives only paid lip service to the issue during the Brexit referendum and 2019 general election to get votes, branding their concern utterly insincere. He said, "Boris Johnson didn't even want to talk about migration in the referendum. In the end, he was forced into it. There was a wonderful cartoon of me drinking a pint of Australian points and him and Michael Gove going into the bar and saying, 'We'll have what he's drinking.' They mentioned it because they got electoral advantage from it. They never meant it. This is the Prime Minister who supported for amnesties for all the illegals when he was Mayor of London. This is the Prime Minister who said, 'Isn't it marvelous now we have got control back over immigration, isn't reducing numbers.' He's never understood this. It doesn't matter to him in any way at all. At the election, he tells the electorate he's going to reduce immigration. It's utterly insincere." Mr. Farage said that he would offer to help, but they would never accept it. "They didn't even ask me for a briefing after I met President Trump. They are not interested in the national interest, just the party interest." But he warned that voters are losing confidence in the Conservatives over immigration and millions may sit on their hands at the next election. The majority of Leave voters, the vast majority of Conservative voters, see immigration as an absolutely defining issue, and he hasn't got a clue how to do this. I think there are millions of people now who literally would not vote. The Corbyn boogeyman has gone. It is difficult to see how Starmer could be worse. They are not taking advantage of Brexit. We have got our country back, but we have not changed politics for good. Quangos and the civil service. The Remainer blob is in charge of everything. He describes himself as a radical in the style of 18th century radicals who wanted to bring change. But he believes that at the moment he can be more influential as a major commentator on GB News, which recently passed Sky News viewer figures and, in his words, is growing. No question about that. I feel like I can influence things in that way, but he has not ruled out a return to politics. Never say never, I am going to think about it. I get emails every day from people who want me to come back. I had 30 this morning. I had one from a couple saying, if you wish to do this again, Mr. Farage, we will send you £1,000 of our hard-earned money. Just an ordinary couple I have never met in my life. I have also had some big donors who are more conservative backers than UKIP backers by history, who are saying this is not a government that believes in the free market, not a government that stands up for the small guy. And will you consider a return? He noted that his former Brexit party, now the Reform Party, is polling at 4%. It's amazing given that the brand name isn't even established yet. Is there an appetite for something? Yes, there really is, he added. There is general disappointment. We have a conservative government that is unconservative in every way. That is big state, is raising taxes. That laughably keeps saying it believes in lower taxes. You can't say one thing and do the other. Even deeper than that, the question is that it is motivated by followership, not leadership. It is utterly rudderless.